So one of the things we get asked here a lot at LEA Professional is, can I set a subnet mask on the static IP network settings on the amplifier? And the answer to that is yes, you can. So let me go into my amplifier here and I'll show you how to do that. So first you're going to click on the little network icon here to bring you into the network settings. So let's say we want to set a static IP address for the wired Ethernet. So first you'd uncheck the DHCP here, and now you see two fields, one for IP address and one for gateway. Well, there's not a field for subnet mask. And that's done on purpose. So we set the subnet mask on our amplifier a little bit differently than a lot of other equipment, but we utilize what's known as CIDR, or the CIDR method. So in order to do this, I'll show you how we can set it up. So first, let's say I want to set a 192.168.1.100 IP address to this amp. And it'll have a gateway of 192.168.1.1. Well, I'm not done yet. So in order to set the subnet mask through the CIDR method, you do a forward slash and then the bit mask equivalent of what the subnet mask is. So most of you are used to setting the subnet mask with 255.255 zeros, a whole combination of different numbers there. Well, what that is actually doing is it is a bit mask. So each of those four digits in the subnet mask that you're used to setting is equivalent to an 8-bit number, or number with 8 bits inside of it. And the subnet mask has to start with all ones and end with all zeros. So if you add up the total number of all the ones in the beginning, you get a number. So if you want to do a 255.255.0.0, those first two digits are 8 bits each, so that'd be a total of 16. So in the IP address here, we can do a forward slash 16, and that will give you the equivalent of 255.255.0.0. So to further explain this, we're going to include a link to the Wikipedia page that talks about the CIDR method, and you can check it out a bit more there. But just know that you can set the subnet mask on our amplifiers. It's pretty straightforward. It's just not the most traditional way that most people are used to setting it. But there you go. Try it out, set the subnet mask on your amplifiers, and let us know what you think.